I'll just try to put it on. Oh, they may be in their homes, they may be in the hospitals, doctors' offices, destitute on street corners, wherever they are today, they are sending forth hope that God Almighty will touch them, that God will send forth His word to heal in the name of Jesus Christ. We know we are not worthy for God to come into our dwelling places, but let Him send forth His word. We thank God that our hands have been cleansed with the blood of Jesus Christ. As we read yesterday from Psalm 24, that who is it that can ascend unto the hills of the Lord? Who? What kind of a person can come before God? That we know our hands must be clean. Amen. Cleansed with the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Our hearts must be pure. We must not have any unrighteous thought, any evil thing in our hearts. Our hearts cannot be added against God or against the children of God, against humanity. We must have the true law of God in us. We must be obedient to the will of God so we can come into the most secret place. We can come into the hills of God. We must not use our hands to create a God, to make our own God, to carve out a God and bow down to idols. We cannot do that. We cannot worship any other God. Amen. In all we do, we must acknowledge the power of God, the God who created us that is truly God. We must acknowledge it before the world. Glory be to God, so that God can defend us, He can keep us safe. Amen. We read Psalm 91 and say that because they acknowledge me, that He will surely defend us, that He will take care of us, He will bless us with long life, He will satisfy us. Amen. That the evil that comes by morning time, by noon, by eventide, by night, by midnight will not come near us. But with our eyes shall we behold and see the recompense of God, the reward of God upon the wicked. Glory be to God, as God rewards the righteous, those who seek God, who have placed their trust in God, who believe in the power of God to save them. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So today we have come with our hearts made up to trust God, to believe in Him, to rely on His word, to feed on His word every day, and to apply the principles that we are learning in the word of God in our daily living. Or else we have no portion with God. Why do we say we are Christians or we are children of God? We cannot apply the spiritual principles that we are learning from the word of God. We need to apply them. And first, but the most important thing is that we must have the love of God for everyone around us, because we have no portion with God if we cannot love. That which brings hatred, that which brings bitterness, that which brings discrimination, tribalism, that brings dividing, people dividing and fighting and causing confusion, cannot be where we congregate, cannot be amongst us. Those are things that are stirred up by the spirit of this world, not the spirit of God that is in us. So, yeah, there is disunity. God cannot bestow a blessing. The word of God says that God bestowed the blessing where there was unity upon Mount Zion, and God commanded life forevermore. The blessings upon the people, life forevermore in the name of Jesus Christ. And that's our portion. Because there, people were united. Amen. That it's so good and pleasant for brethren to be in unity or in harmony. Amen. When they come together. And it was compared to the anointing oil, the oil that was poured upon the head of Aaron, that went through his hair, through his robe, and overflowed. Amen. That is compared to the dew of the morning, the dew upon Mount Hermon, upon Mount Zion, the dew of the morning. How beautiful, how peaceful it is when people really come together, brethren come together, communities come together. Amen. We are seeing what is happening despite the devastation of the hurricane in Texas. We can see how human beings can truly show the love of God in times when there's instability, when people are not sure of what will happen next. Amen. You see the goodness of men start coming up, because at that time everybody realizes that we do not even have control over our lives. Anything can happen. Imagine this river has been there years since. Look at the way the river has come up with such a force against us. So people come together. That how beautiful, how pleasant it is when brethren dwell in harmony, when communities dwell in harmony, when communities uproot the spirit of discrimination, that means bring bitterness, hatred, that make people to see themselves differently. I've been watching, following the news closely, because I want to know what is happening in where the storm, the areas being affected by the storm. I want to know what is happening. We have a lot of friends in who will not know. We have the children of God there. So we want to know how to direct our prayers. We want to know what to do. So I've been following closely. And I see it doesn't, different races, whether like you're white people rescuing black people, it's different people. You know, they are coming together. The police officers, the first responders, doing great works. Amen. Glory be to God. That's what God wants us to do in our communities. Not when something shakes our foundation. No. Not only then that we do things like that, that we just realize, oh, how little we are upon the surface of the earth. Without God, anything can happen. The water can come against us. Things can happen in the elements against us. We need to come together. Amen. To be united. Not just then. Even when nothing is happening, that's the way we should be. We should interact with one another in this world. You can see the first responder that was carrying a woman that was carrying a baby. Yesterday night, it was on. I was just looking at it and say, oh God, how beautiful. Look at what is happening here. The weight of the mom and the baby on the mother's hand. And the man was carrying them to safety. Amen. Glory be to God. We need to praise God. We need to thank God. God gets our attention through different ways. Just a couple of weeks ago, precisely August 12, people were marching down the street and chanting things that were contrary to the will of God, invoking evil things that should not be said. I won't repeat it. That cannot be said. Not in this time and seasons of our existence. These things that should not be said. There are beautiful people everywhere. There are God-fearing people everywhere. And praise God, praise God, praise God that in various communities that people have spoken against what they saw, what they heard, that was not good. Because at this time, we should be thinking about where we want to spend eternal life. We want to spend, what is our purpose here on earth? We did not bring ourselves into this world. Even if we came through our parents bringing us in through conception, through delivering, bringing us into this world, God is still in control of our lives. God gave us to our parents. So we must surrender ourselves to the will of God and let God reign. Reign in majesty, reign supreme wherever we are in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. So today, as we have come together, I thank you that I've called you this morning, my dear brother, Mr. Amashie Amewero. Thank you. God bless you and your beautiful family. God bless you and your ministry. I saw you with the Shekiri Iwere conference. What you did last weekend. That was beautiful. The dressing, the way you dressed your son. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, my dear brother. Sokolu, Dr. Sokolu Chineke, thank you for calling in. God bless you and your family. Good to see your mom, your wife, and everyone over there. Glory be to God. Those of you I cannot see this morning, God bless you. God bless you as you call in, as you listen to this message in Jesus' mighty and precious name. I will start by reading Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord almighty words. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. No matter what is happening today, no matter what we know, it doesn't matter what we know or what we have seen, the voice of the Lord is over the waters. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The Lord of glory thunders. The Lord thunders over the mighty waters. Hallelujah. The Lord thunders over the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is majestic. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks in pieces the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon skip like a calf. Sarion like a young white horse. The voice of the Lord strikes the flashes of lightning. The voice of the Lord shakes the desert. The Lord shakes the desert of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord treats the ox and strips the forest bare. And in his temple all cry glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord is enthroned as king forever. The Lord gives strength to his people. The Lord blesses his people with peace. The Lord blesses us with peace. He wants us to be in peace. Whether the water is tearing up, the voice of the Lord is over, is mightier than that water. The Lord thunders over that water. The Lord thunders over the lightning, the thunder. The Lord thunders over the great waters, over the cedars, whatever it is that has been stirred up, whatever it is that is causing confusion, the voice of God is over it. Glory be to God. And we believe that our God is powerful, that our God is able to restore order, amen, to the regions that have been affected by this hurricane. The Lord is able to restore order to our life situations, to our families, our marriages. God is able to restore order to our governments in the name of Jesus Christ. God is able to restore order. Whatever we are passing through today, the voice of the Lord thunders over it. The voice of God is mightier than any situation of life. The voice of God is bringing peace to us today. The peace of God that surpasses human understanding. The voice of God is bringing healing to us today. In every situation, we receive wholeness of spirit, mind, body, and souls. The voice of God is speaking today, speaking better things than the blood of Abel. That voice of God is speaking through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We invoke the blood of Jesus today over every situation today, over us all wickedness, over devastation coming from these flood waters. The voice of God is speaking today against wind bringing devastation. The voice of God is mighty today. The voice of God is speaking peace to our situation. The voice of God is speaking comfort, bringing encouragement to us today. The voice of God is bringing healing in every situation. The voice of God is settling that situation, that matter that appears large. The voice of God is taking control today. The voice of our God is speaking today. He's speaking into us today. The word of God is penetrating through every situation. The voice of God is holding back the powers of the satanic powers, the things coming to the will of God and commanding the elements to obey. Oh, Rabbi Shimon, about the voice of God today, to be still in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The voice of God, it's speaking to me in the name of Jesus Christ. God is bringing peace and consolation today. God is bringing comfort in the name of Jesus Christ. God is bringing comfort. The sky, oh Lord God, soul will comfort in the name of Jesus Christ. The flood water will receive back to the ocean. God, you restore to your children things that have been taken from them. You send comfort in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, the family of God, where the children died with their great grandparents. Oh, send forth comfort to the police officer who was drowned. Comfort to the family in the name of Jesus Christ. Comfort to those that we did not know. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ, your voice is speaking today. Peace in every situation. The peace of God in the name of Jesus Christ. The peace of God in the name of Jesus Christ. What is the situation today? The voice of God thunders over it in the name of Jesus Christ. Over infertility, over poverty, over anything the enemy has brought against us, over us with wickedness, communal wickedness, over satanic altars. The voice of God is thundering over them today in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God is mighty over poverty, over lack, over sorrow. The voice of God in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God is breaking everything that should be broken, establishing his will, shaking down everything that is shaking down in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God, it is majestic, it is powerful. The voice of God, send forth peace and healing to us, send forth comfort in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God is speaking today. The word of God is established in the name of Jesus Christ. It's established in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God is speaking good things concerning us and our situations in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we give you thanks. We bless you, God. We believe, Lord God, that your voice is mighty over the waters, over the deep waters. Your voice is mighty. The voice of God. Glory be to God. The word of God has spoken to us, bringing comfort to us, giving us inner strength to prevail. Oh, Rabahaba Shadaraba, leading Father Lord, the first responders, in the name of Jesus Christ, to rescue your children from the flood waters. The voice of God is speaking today, in the name of Jesus Christ, to our government. Oh, Rabahaba Shadara, the voice of God is speaking, in the name of Jesus Christ, to every situation, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are attentive to your voice this day, in the name of Jesus Christ, as wisdom leaders, leads us wherever we go today, in the name of Jesus Christ. May your perfect will be done here on earth as it is in heaven, in the name of Jesus Christ. Your voice is speaking, oh Rabakaha, concerning barrenness that which bring, oh Lord God, sorrow that bring, Father Lord, sadness that bring weeping, in the name of Jesus Christ. We overturn by the power of the living God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, you have brought fruitfulness to us, that husbands are receiving power to impregnate their wives, wives receiving power to carry pregnancy to full terms, in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God is speaking, Father Lord, the doctors are hearing, nurses are hearing, Father Lord, or in the medical profession, they are hearing you, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, technicians are hearing, pharmacists are hearing, in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God is speaking. You are helping them, you need him center, to carry out various procedures on your children, holding the hands of the doctors and the nurses. Jehovah God, we thank you. The voice of God is speaking today concerning situations in our families, in our marriages, in the lives of our children, in our father's households, the households we are married to, our communities of origin, the communities we dwell in, our common nations of the world and the body of Christ. The voice of God has spoken peace to our situation, prosperity, fruitfulness in every area. The voice of God has spoken. We do not lack any spiritual gifts. God has blessed us with all spiritual gifts in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. The rod of oppression cannot be placed on the land that God has given to us. God Almighty, you have spoken. You have made barren land to fall upon us in pleasant places. We have a good inheritance in you. We bless you this morning for what you have done for us. Glory be to your name. Glory be to your name, our Father. We thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ speaking on our behalf today. We invoke that blood of Jesus Christ in every heaven center over every situation that we find ourselves in today. Oh, blood of Jesus, begin to speak for us. Begin to speak against spiritual wickedness. Begin to disgrace those that are gathered together for evil purposes. Let them fall into the pit they have done with their hands. Let them be overtaken by their own evil desires. In the name of Jesus Christ, let them be confused as they gather together. May they not agree on anything relating to us in the spiritual realm. We confuse them. We overturn every exchange is done contrary to the will of God. In the name of Jesus Christ, our names and the names of our loved ones cannot be called or fought by any satanic altar. In the name of Jesus Christ, we come against the priests bearing those altars, and those who took our names there, they are falling by the power of the living God. Oh, Robert Shedda, the righteous judgment of God is against them. They are falling in the name of Jesus Christ. They are falling in the name of Jesus Christ. They are confused in the name of Jesus Christ. We are chasing them in this spiritual realm. We are taking back everything that belongs to us in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. There's restoration to us of everything that belongs to us and our fathers as old, our mothers as old, the assholes we are married to, in the name of Jesus Christ. You are our lot and portion in the land of the living. No evil shall prevail against us and our families. No evil shall prevail against the nations. Father, it's as you said it to be. That's the way it will be here on earth as it is in heaven. That's the way it will be. I will say, Father, take the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. In every situation, we give you thanks. We bless you. We thank you because you are working out things for us. Oh, God Almighty, everything we work out for our good in Jesus' mighty name. We commit unto your hands this morning, the body of Christ. We thank you that church is united in one voice. You bestow the blessing upon us when we are united. We come against the spirit of division. We come against false prophets and teachers. We come against Father Lord, ungodly exchanges done in the house of God. We overturn the tables of money changers. Thank you, Lord, your fathers and mothers that will seek you, that will obey your word concerning the congregation of God's children. Thank you, Lord God, for such leaders, Lord God, that will willingly open up their doors to help, Lord God, your children, Father Lord, at this difficult time. That will send, Father Lord, relief aid, Lord God, to the hurricane zone, to people who need, that will continue to support missions in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, the doors of the church cannot be closed. They must be open to all nations, all tribes, all ethnicity, all languages, Son of God. All people can come in. Your house is a house of prayer, a house of deliverance, a place that people run to. Rabbi Shendara, for help in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless you for the church of Christ. We thank you that we will not discredit our own testimonies, that we are your children, Jehovah God. We repent in ways, Lord God, that we have sinned against you, in ways that we have used human wisdom to resolve situations, or in ways that we have made mistakes.
mistake, oh Lord God. In ways that we have set up, oh Lord God, arguments, oh Lord God, and people talking against the church, have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. Have mercy upon us in the name of Jesus Christ. May we truly show the love of God to everyone. Father, we thank you for your Holy Spirit. May your Spirit continue to lead us. Thank you, we bless your Spirit. We thank you, God, for what you have done for us. We thank you that we are united. We thank you, Jehovah God, that we are disciplined. We bless you, God Almighty. There is no confusion where we are. We thank you for your peace, Lord God. We thank you that we prosper in our ministry work in the name of Jesus Christ. We lift up the Great Commission. We thank you as we go forth into the uttermost ends of the world to preach this gospel. You are leading us, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus Christ. May your will be done. We thank your muscles that you come to your kingdom, you will be to God. We present to you the persecuted church, Lord God. Blessed are they that are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for they shall inherit your kingdom. Father, anyone using the organ of government against the church, let them be brought down by the power of the living God. Let your right hand, Lord God, be lifted up against them. Let them brought down in the name of Jesus Christ. Let them suffer much for the church of Christ as they have persecuted the church in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We thank for signs, miracles, and wonders that have been done, Lord God, through your children as they go around the world in the name of Jesus Christ. Your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our hearts, Lord God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Darkness cannot find any place to hide as we go out, Lord God, to preach this gospel. Thank you for the power you have given to us to become your children, Jehovah God. We bless you today, you are our Father. There's no God that's there. Glory be to your name. Thank you for placing us in our rightful positions in our ministry, in our families, in our marriages, in our homes, in our communities, on our jobs, Lord God. Within the body of Christ, wherever we go, in the name of Jesus Christ, you are leading us through life. Oh, Rahim, the center of our worship. We are aware, oh Lord God, of your abiding presence in all our situations, Jehovah God. You are lifted up our heads above our enemies. We bless you this day. Glory be to God. We commit unto your hands and marriages, Lord God. We thank you that you have called, Lord God, unto united in holy matrimony and in ministry work. No weapon fashioned against our household will prosper. In vain we get gathered. They cannot penetrate into our relationship. We set fire against anyone attempting, Lord God, to disrupt, oh Lord God, the peace of God in our homes today. We come against them. We send curses upon them. We put them up by the power of the living God. We send, Father, Lord, Rabba Haba, your word says that whosoever we curse on earth is cursed in heaven. We come against them, Father, Lord, anyone attempting, Lord, cause confusion, cause sorrow in our homes. We come against them. We pull them down. Evil counselors, we come against you in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of God concerning us and our family prevails in every situation. We thank you that within our homes are shouts of victory and rejoicing. Thank you for the children you have blessed us with, Jehovah God. They have brought strength to us. Nobody, Lord God, can use our children for any evil purposes. Father, Lord, they shall achieve the purpose for which you created them. They shall get married in their own homes, Lord God. Acquire skills and education to call responsible citizens of their families and communities, Lord God. Father, they will be strong pillars within your house. They will bring monsters into your kingdom. Father, Lord, they will show the way to so many people. Jehovah God, they will be found in every good profession. In the name of Jesus Christ, they shall eat of the fat of the land. In the name of Jesus Christ, they cannot be used for any evil purposes. No one can cast any spell against them. We break and loosen every knot tied by the power of the living God. We break every chain. We deliver our children and give them inner strength to pursue all of God, the attackers, Lord God, to trap upon the attackers, to bring down the great scorpion and the cobra, oh Lord God Almighty, the serpent and everything that stands in the way. We give our children strength, Lord God, to pull and take that which belongs to them in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you, we bless you, we cut air off every evil cause in the name of Jesus Christ. No evil shall prevail against us and our families in Jesus' mighty name. Today we lift up a standard against those bringing drugs into our communities, those teaching children in sex trade and child labor, those enticing children to run away from their communities and families, those that are exposing our children to pornography. Oh God Almighty, we come against them in the name of Jesus Christ. Those recruiting children in gangs, Lord God, and terrorist sites, we come against you. You are not doing good works in our communities. You are attempting to destroy the next generation. We come against you. Oh Rabba Haba, the word of God is against you. The blood of Jesus Christ is against you. Rabba Shendra, Baba Shendra, you cannot enjoy any evil money. Oh Rabba Shendra, turn back to God and repent of your sin in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, be separated from our children. Be separated from our children. Be separated from the schools. Oh Rabba Shendra, Baba, from the sporting activities of our children. Be separated. Rabba Shendra, Baba Shendra, by the power of the living God. We need to be standing today in the name of Jesus Christ. We send a hedge of fire around our children. Let be a cleansing out of evil from our schools, university, colleges, daycare, primary school, elementary schools, oh Lord God, middle schools, oh Lord God, high schools, in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever our children are today, Father, protect them from evil. Those in summer camp, protect them. In the name of Jesus Christ, those on holiday, protect them. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are our Father, we bless you. No evil shall prevail against us and our families. Father, we say thank you, God, for encompassing around us with your holy presence, as Matthew encompasses around Jerusalem, for providing for our needs today, for breaking every snare and making bringing our souls to escape as birds under the fallen snake. Father, we say thank you for your love giving us as prey under the teeth of the wicked. We bless you, Jehovah Rehimson, for the Lord is with us. We bless you, Baba, Baba, we are saying you are with us, so that no evil can try to prevail against us. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bless you, God. We give you a clap offering as we bring before you today all the food processing plants around the world. We have our water, drinking water, everything that goes into our mouth, everything we use in our personal and medical care, wherever they are produced, processed, along our manufactured. Jehovah Rehimson, we come against which are wickedness in those places. We lift up a standard in the name of Jesus Christ. Against anyone trying to poison us. Anyone selling cancer. We come against you. Oh, Rababa Shindara Baba 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 Baba. Whatever disease you are sending around the world, as you are injecting things into our food, as you are drinking water, we come against you. We set fire against you. We bring you down by the power of the living God. Rababa Baba Shindara Baba Baba. God thunders in the name of the Son, and the voice of God in the Baba thunders over the wickedness today. We bring you down. We set fire upon your head. The word of God prevails against you. You cannot continue to inject it into the food of God's children. You cannot continue to do evil against the communities of God's children. We come against you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bring you down. Evil money will not benefit you. Oh, Rababa Shindara, what can you give back in essence of your soul? Rababa Shindara, Rababa Shindara, what did it profit you to gain this entire world? Oh, Rababa Shindara, Rababa, to the loss of your own soul. Rababa Shindara, Rababa, we come against your evil money. The word of God says we should seek for the kingdom of God and its righteousness, and every other thing shall be added unto us. Remember, Shindara, seek the kingdom of God. See the righteousness of the kingdom of God. Oh, bow down to the mighty hands of God. The voice of God turns. Remember, Shindara, over spiritual wickedness, over us on wickedness, over communal wickedness, in the name of Jesus Christ, over institutional wickedness and corruption, in the name of Jesus Christ. The voice of God turns. Remember, Shindara, over Shindara, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we say thank you, God, for being our God and helper. Thank you for letting our eyes see to the living God. We thank you that you help us to pray. We do not know to pray what we ought to pray about. Remember, Shindara, over Shindara, help us in our intercession. Remember, Shindara, over Shindara, in grace with God, understands. Help us in our intercession, as we intercede this day. Help us in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember, Shindara, remember, Shindara, those which are wicked, we stand against us and our families. In the name of Jesus Christ. So that we give it thanks. We bless you this morning. We know that you have answered our prayers and we have not come to you in vain. We have come believing. We have come asking. We have come receiving. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whosoever asks, your box shall receive. Whosoever knocks, the door shall be opened unto out of there. In the name of Jesus Christ. Whoever seeks shall find you. In the name of Jesus Christ. When we draw near to you, you draw near to us. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, we thank you. We touch you. We cannot bear any fruit. We are remaining in our rightful position within Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Greater are you in us than the spirit in this world. Greater are you in us than the spirit in this world. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we say thank you for everything you have done for us this day. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, we have prayed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord God bring it. Blessed be our God. May the rock of our salvation be exalted. May God be exalted in our lives today in the name of Jesus Christ. It's our God. He will never fail us. He has sent help to us. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We believe in the help of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to read a few verses of Psalm 27. I actually had something open here this morning too. Let me see. I will read it. Mark chapter 4. The parable of the mustard seed. The parable of the mustard seed, and I'll read the Jesus calms the storm. The one following Mark 4, beginning from verse 30. Again, he said, "What shall we say the kingdom of God is like, or what parable shall we use to describe it? It is like a mustard seed, which is the smallest seed you plant in the ground." A mustard seed, which is the smallest seed you plant in the ground, yet when planted, it grows and becomes the largest of all garden plants, with such big branches that the birds of the air can perch in its shade. With many similar parables, Jesus spoke the word to them as much as they could understand. He did not say anything to them without using a parable, but when he was alone with his own disciples, he explained everything. So the kingdom of God, Jesus Christ described the kingdom of God as like a small mustard seed, the smallest of all seed. But when it's planted in the ground, it grows. Yet when it grows and becomes the largest of all garden plants, with such big branches that the birds of the air can perch on its shade. The word of God, any aspect of the word of God that we have received may be little, very small. But that word can produce the fruit of righteousness in us. That word can transform our life, our life situations, our communities, lives of people around us. Just a little seed that we receive. That the soil went and was sown. The seed fell in different places. Amen. But the seed that fell can be compared to this little mustard seed. The ones that yielded a 100-fold, 60-fold, 30-fold. Amen. That fell on good soil. So the soils of our hearts must be ready to receive that small word that will come in. It may be small. You may not say it. It may come out from your mouth. It may sound carelessly. Like telling somebody that God loves you. Do you know I'm a born again? Do you know Jesus Christ died for us? Do you know God gave us salvation? Do you know the plan of God for salvation of mankind? Do you know God loves us so much? Little things. It may not drop somewhere. You may not even think that it has found a ground, a fertile ground in somebody. It's the smallest seed. It has fallen. You may not even know that person is meditating upon that word that you spoke. That's why we must publish the word of God. We must say it. Because we do not know the fertile ground. Yet this small word that you have spoken will not germinate as a big tree that will impact an entire community, entire family. Amen. That can impact friends of that person. Amen. A little seed was spoken to us. We may not even know at the time that seed was spoken into us. It may be by our parents. It may be by a teacher in our schools. Someone that turned our life around, the path that we are walking on, a small seed, a small word of wisdom, a small counsel coming from God, spoken into us, has become a large thing that we actually feed on it and believe no one can take it from us. Because that's enlightened our spiritual eyes, increase our understanding, increase our faith. To believe in the power of God, like a small seed. You may have a very tiny seed today, that what can I do with this small seed? But it's the word of God spoken. How many people can this seed impact? Of what good will this seed be? If it's in your mouth and has been given to you, speak it. Let utter it. Let it come out. Know that it is life, it is spirit. That is, it will fall on a fertile ground, on a fertile soil. You may not even be aware of it. Amen. But God will do what God alone can do. We must speak it. We must say it. We must plant it. It's already in our mouth. It's tied around our necks as tablets that we pull out to use in situations. It's engrafted or ingrained in our hearts for us to pull out to use the word of God. It's overflowing from our bellies as rivers of waters, living waters. It is in us. Little seed sown in us. It enlightens our eyes to see beyond our natural environments, to see spiritual things, to believe in the power of God to save us. That the word of God is mightier than the waters or the elements, anything that we may see with our physical eyes today. A small seed. That seed is in us. Amen. Sown in us. We can sow it in people in the name of Jesus Christ. May we begin to testify about the faithfulness of God. Sow it, this small seed, tiny seed. Amen. It is like a mustard seed, which is the smallest seed you plant in the ground. Smallest. A heart of kindness to somebody can turn that person's heart around. Even the person meant evil against you, I've been saying things, gossiping about you. Then the person has the opportunity to see you and finds out that everything I've been hearing about this person is so different. What were they saying? Look at what this person just did for me. that can turn a person's life, the direction of a person around a small seed. Amen. We have it in us. Let us be ready to plant it wherever we go in the name of Jesus Christ. It will grow. The birds of the air will come to perch on it. They will come to make their nest on it, to lay their eggs, amen, in it. Let us be ready to plant this wherever God will lead us. The word of God is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our paths. Dispelling darkness. Darkness cannot find anywhere to hide wherever we pass through in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to God. That Jesus Christ spoke to the people in parables, amen, as much as they could. That with many similar parables, Jesus spoke the word to them as much as they could understand, as much as they could understand. Thank God that the Spirit helps us in our understanding. The Spirit enlightens us. The Spirit helps us in our prayer. The Spirit is helping us every day to understand the things that we may not even understand yesterday from the same passage. When we come back and we read it, the Spirit enlightens us. Glory be to God. So Jesus Christ spoke this in parable. Parable have a lot of meaning. Very powerful. If we are said it in plain words, perhaps it will just pass through. But in parables, let them go, ponder, think about it, meditate about it, think about it. Where it goes inside, inwardly, and the meaning, reflect on it, and the meaning starts coming out. Amen. Think about it. Think about it. Imagine the mustard seed. Imagine how small it is. Imagine that how can that seed become the lightest of all seeds, of all plants that want to come and fetch on it. How is that possible? Let them go think about it so that they can receive a revelation from God. What the power of God, what the Spirit alone can do in the name of Jesus Christ. But to his disciples, he spoke to them. He explained everything he meant to his disciples, those who walked with him. Because when Jesus Christ was taken away from this world, they continued with the ministry. They needed to understand so many things to know what to do. Amen. When Jesus Christ will no longer be with them. Glory be to God. I'm continuing. Jesus calms the storm. Mark chapter 4, verse 35. That day when evening came, he said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." It's always on the other side. Amen. Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along, just as he was in the boat. There were also other boats with them. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boats. That's like a waves, very strong waves came up, and the waves broke over the boats, so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciple woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" He got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. He said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" They were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him." The same Jesus Christ, yesterday, today, tomorrow, forevermore the same. Whatever waves may be stirring up today in our lives, what we have seen within the past couple of days has disturbed a lot of us. Let us know that Jesus Christ is still our Lord and Savior, that he can still calm the waves, he can still give back to his children more than that flood water has destroyed. In the name of Jesus Christ, those that died and passed on, to God be the glory. God has a plan for every situation. May God send comfort to the families of those mourning the death of loved ones in Jesus' mighty name. May we never forget that Jesus Christ is the same. Whatever the situation is the same. So today we are calling him to take control of the waves, the storm water, whatever is happening. We are joining our voices together, and we believe that God will answer us, that things will return to normalcy, that things will become normal again in those regions in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, he is God. We thank you, God, for your faithfulness. We know that you will not leave us alone without help. There is help for us in the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. Enjoy the rest of your day. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. I thank you, my dear brother Gideon Efosa, for calling in this morning. I think this is the first time I've seen you on this program. God bless you and your family and your ministry. Glory be to God. And my dear sister, Missa Koku, God bless you and your family and your ministry. Enjoy the rest of the day, all of you. God bless you all. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Amen.